We have first speaker will be Pedro Luis Chinchilla, and then Connie will do the translation, and then we have Juan Jose to do the second piece, and Finbar will do the translation.
Y al quinto día vino tan gran temporal y travesía, con mar por el cielo, de suerte que las amarras no pudieron tener ni las velas servir. Y fuimos a embestir con todas tres naos en una playa llena de arena bien chica, cercada de grandísimos peñascos de una parte y de otra, cosa jamás vista. Porque en espacio de una hora se hicieron todas las tres naos pedazos, de las cuales no escaparon 300 hombres y se ahogaron más de 1000, y entre ellos mucha gente principal, capitanes, caballeros y otros entretenidos.
On the fifth day, there sprang up so great a storm on our beam, with a sea up to the heavens, so that the cables could not hold, nor the sails serve us, and we were driven ashore with all three ships upon the beach, covered with a very fine sand, shut in on one side and the other by great rocks. Such a thing was never seen, for within the space of an hour all three ships were broken in pieces, so that they did not escape 300 men, and more than 1,000 were drowned, among them many persons of importance, captains, gentlemen, and others.
El don Diego Enríquez murió allí más tristemente que en el mundo se ha visto, porque con temor de la grandísima mar que había, que pasaba por cima a las naos, tomó la barca de su nao, que tenía cubierto, y con él el hijo del conde de Villafranca y otros dos caballeros portugueses, con más de 16.000 ducados en joyas y escudos. Se metieron debajo de la cubierta de la dicha barca y mandaron cerrar y calafatear el escotillón, por donde entraron y luego se arrojaron de la nao en la barca más de 70 hombres que habían quedado vivos, y queriéndola encaminar hacia tierra, vino sobre ella una tan gran mar que la hundió y arrebató la gente que sobre ella iba. Y luego se anduvo volteando con los mares de acá para allá, hasta que vino a tierra, donde se sentó lo de arriba hacia abajo, y en estos lances los caballeros que se habían metido.
Don Diego Enriquez died there, one of the saddest deaths that has ever been seen in the world. In consequence of fearing the very heavy sea that was washing over the highest part of the wrecks, he took his ship's boat that was decked, and he and the son of the Count of Villafranca and two other Portuguese gentlemen, with more than 16,000 ducats in jewels and crown pieces, placed themselves under the deck of the said boat and gave the order to close and caught the hatchway by which he had entered. Thereupon more than 70 men who had remained alive jumped from the ship to the boat, and while she was making for the land, some great wave washed over her as she sank, and all the deck were swept away. Then she drifted along, rolling over in different directions with the waves, until she went ashore, where she settled wrong side up, and by these were the chances the gentlemen who had placed themselves under the deck died.